Hey guys, welcome back to electronicsinnovation.com. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to build this IoT-based air quality monitoring system. I'm going to name this project as Airsense project. So in the whole video, we are going to talk more about the circuit designing part, manufacturing of this PCB, and finally assembling the whole device into this form factor. By the way, this project is sponsored by PCBWAY.com by sending these PCBs. So we are going to talk more about the PCBWAY.com when we are ordering these PCBs on their website. So what are we waiting for? Let's dive into the episode. In the previous episode, I made this indoor air quality monitoring system which measures and displays PM2.5 and PM10, temperature and humidity, gas resistance and estimated CO2, pressure and altitude. The air quality system is working perfectly and providing accurate information. However, as you can see here, it is assembled on a temporary breadboard and occupies more space. So I have decided to make a PCB where it will be assembled permanently within a smaller footprint. Additionally, the project is offline based and I am unable to track the data. There is no history of the data available. All we can see is the instantaneous data. To mitigate these, I wanted to provide IoT capabilities to the device and push all the data to the cloud. This way, we can have a history of the data. This diagram illustrates how these modules and sensors are interfaced in the previous project. This circuit that will allow us to interface the same modules and sensor on a PCB. Here, we have an ESP8266 module, OLED display and BME680 sensor. These two devices will communicate with ESP8266 module over I2C communication. I have also placed two pull-up resistors here because the I2C communication requires pull-up resistors to ensure proper signal levels, prevent bus contentions, and maintain signal integrity in open drain configuration. In general, these two modules will work without pull-up resistors on the I2C lines. But if any issues arises while working, I could simply populate these two resistors and solve the issue. On the other side, I have added the connector to interface the SDS-01 sensor using RX and TX lines. On top of that, I have also given provision to power this whole circuit through VIN and ground. This is a 12 volts to 5 volts voltage regulator. I have added this to power the circuit with 12 volts input. In this, I am using LM7805, which is a popular voltage regulator option that can support up to 1.5 amperes, which is more than enough for our device. The input to this circuit can be provided using the DC socket and Phoenix connector. Here, I have added 2-pin straight header to act as a switch for this input. I have added these input filters which filter high frequency noise, improve transient response and observe voltage spikes. Then we have the LM7805, a positive voltage regulator that employs internal current limiting, thermal shutdown and safe area compensation, making it essentially indestructible. On the output side, I have also added these two capacitors which will stabilize the voltage regulations, reduce the output ripple, enhances transient response and minimizes output noise. Then again, we have a 2-pin straight header to act as a switch for the output. I have also added one more option to power this device, which is a lithium-ion battery that can be connected here along with its BMS. BMS means a battery management system TP4056. This TP4056 is a single cell BMS. I've clearly explained how this single cell BMS takes care of this lithium ion cell in this previous video. You can check that out if you are interested. VIN can be selected from this header. If you want to power through 5 volts, simply short these two pins. Or if you want to power through battery or a cell, you can short these two with the jumper. That's it. So that's all about the quick tour through the schematic diagram of this AirSense project. So I have converted the schematic into the PCB file and completed the component placement and routing part. This is just a two-layer PCB, and here's the final outcome. This is the top layer. On the top layer, we have ESP8266 module, OLED display, and BME680 sensor. And also the 4-pin connector for the PM sensor. Also the voltage regulation section. This is the bottom layer. On the bottom layer, we don't have much components, but I've mounted this TP4056 cell BMS so that I can save space on the top layer. Okay, that's all about the placement. So our PCB could look something like this in a real time. So it's just a rendered image. This is the top side of the PCB, and the bottom side of the PCB could be something like this. Once the designing part is completed, I have generated fabrication files of the PCB, also known as cover files, and saved them into my computer. Now, let's quickly visit the PCB manufacturer website and order these PCBs. For this, I'm choosing PCBWAY.com. PCBWAY.com is an online PCB manufacturing enterprise that offers high-quality PCBs for just $5. They provide all the services you need to create hardware for your IoT or embedded devices, including PCB prototyping, PCB assembly, manufacturing of FPC or rigid flex PCBs, and offering CNC and 3D printing services. If you have a similar requirements, be sure to visit their website for more details using the link mentioned in the description. To order PCBs on the PCBWAY.com, select the option PCB prototype and then enter the dimensions of the PCB. In my case, it is 70mm length and 70mm weight. Then choose the required quantity. For me, it's just 10 pieces. Then select the layer and thickness based on the requirement. Then click on Quote Now. Then a detailed PCB specification selection page will open. Board type single piece, verify the quantity and layers. Then you can keep the rest of the settings default as shown here, which follows a standard spec. Select the solder mask. This one will decide the color of the PCB. You might have seen PCBs within green color, blue color, and black color. So this is what that decides the PCB color. So in my case, I'll go with the blue and select the silk screen. I'm going with the white because the white color will look more clear on the blue PCB. Then surface finish will be HASL with the LED. Then keep the settings default and click on calculate button. Then select the build time. I'm going with 3 to 4 days, which is a cheaper option than others. Then select the shipping method and your country where you wanted to deliver these PCBs. In my case, it's the India. Then click on save to cart. Now a new pop-up window will open to allow you to upload the cover files. Here is the cover file I've generated for this project. Select it and submit the order now. Then you will see this page. Here you can see the status of the order. Now it is mentioned as subject to audit. At this time, some folks from the PCB will review our cover files, whether the design can be manufacturable or not. If everything is good, they'll approve the design. So let's come back again and check the status. Oh, now the status has been changed to being reviewed. Now someone from the PCB is actually working on it. Okay, the audit has been completed and our device got a green signal for fabrication. Yo, we can also see how our PCB is going to be based on our solder mask and silk screen preferences. Here is the top side and here is the bottom side. Okay, and now we can proceed to the payment. PCBWAY.com accepts various payment methods. Choose the suitable method and complete the payment by clicking on the place order button. Once the payment is successful and the order is placed, you can find your order in the products status tab. You can click on the view details to monitor each step of the fabrication process as shown here. Once the fabrication is completed, the status will be something like this. Then the parcel will be shipped through your preferred shipping method, and you can track it using the tracking ID provided here. The parcel will be delivered to you safely. I've got the parcel delivered to my home within just 4 days. Imagine, from China to India, that too with all custom clearances in just 4 days. It's magic. So, we will unbox the package in the next video. I've decided to do that in another video because this video is already became very long. So, we'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.